Ready, set, go.
Okay, so these are the C-carriages assembled with the Y-axis rail. Okay, so the Y-axis linear rail is on right here. So the way this works is underneath it, we have these cutouts right here, right? We originally wanted to have this closed. Now, the problem with having it closed was it made assembly and disassembly a lot more complicated, okay? So what we did is we kept it closed, but we had a cutout, right? So the way the assembly works is basically you have to tap this extrusion with an M5, okay? So if you notice, I have two M5 dome screws right here, okay? Now, it's very important that you get this extrusion the right distance, okay? This is probably the most important extrusion out of all of them. This one has to be the right length, okay? If it's not the right length, it'll create a mechanical bind. And you'll know, if it moves smooth, you're good. If it moves and it's choppy, you got some kind of mechanical bind. But anyways, so the way these C-carriages are designed is it's got an opening right here, right? This is clearance to get over for assembly, to get over the extrusion. Okay, so you have these X-axis 20 by 40 millimeter extrusions, right? These are linear rails. Here's the carriage block right here, and the carriage block right here, right? So what you want to do is you want to move the inserts over to the side where they're even, and move the carriage blocks over to the side where they're even, right? Okay, so the way this works is you're going to hover over. Now notice I'm to the side of the carriage block, right? So I'm going to hover over, and I'm going to slide down. And when I do that, I'm going to slide, once I get in position, I'm going to slide over and place it down on two B carriage blocks. Okay, so next thing you do is you're just going to line this up, line the holes up. It's going to be a 9mm long M3 cap screw, okay? You could probably use dome screws. Alright, so you're gonna get these nice and tight. Gonna do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so it's very important that these cap screw heads screw all the way in and sink into the counterboard, okay? You do not want any of the screw head sticking up above the surface, okay? Reason why is there's going to be a motor mount that mounts right here, and it has to be completely flat, okay? If it's not completely flat, you're going to have mechanical bind, and you're going to have problems. Okay, so... So this is the x-axis, right? So we got our x-axis linear rails, and we got our y-axis linear rails. Now, if it's hard to move, that means there's a mechanical bind, okay? So What you want to watch out for is you want to make sure that this moves freely, okay? If it's really choppy or it's really hard to press and move, you're going to wear your bearings out and your linear rails out pretty fast. But anyways, so we'll go ahead and place this here. We're going to go ahead and mount the NEMA 23 Y-axis motor, and we're going to mount the idler mount right here, okay? After that, what we're going to do is we're going to lock these lead screw nut inserts. They're going to go inside the carriage, okay? Right now, we're not too worried about them, so we'll come back and get them later. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is this is my NEMA 23 Y-axis motor mount right here. Okay, it's going to be positioned like this. Okay, so your Y-axis motor mount is also going to use M3 cap screws. Okay, same thing. Make sure these M3s are screwed all the way in, nice, firmly. Make sure the head of the cap screw sinks into the counterbore, okay? It should not be above the surface. All right, so next, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna lock down the Y-axis motor idler mount. And just like the other components, it uses 9mm M3 cap screws.
Whoa!
Okay, next, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mount my extruder carriage, okay? So this is it's a little bit different than the typical C-carriage. The whole bottom in is out, and it's made for motors to mount to. I'm sorry, it's made for extruders and hot ends to mount to. Okay, so the way this is going to work is you take your Y-axis hot end carriage,
put it over. And it's going to work the same way.
And three cat screws.
Okay, should move freely.